Okay, let's do it. Your Dennis Ugas of Cuba blames Terence Crawford for not getting the undisputed fight. This is what your Dennis Ugas had to say. Unbelievable that this fight looks like it's gonna happen, but to the surprised at 154, no titles on the line. He's obviously referring to the news that broke yesterday, made a video about it, Errol Spence versus Keith Thurman is looking likely. He says, this is still a great fight, even though it's at 154, with some of the best lads of this generation, but what a disappointment. Amazing how the undisputed 147, this is the part you got to pay attention to. He says, amazing how the undisputed 147 pound welterweight fight, championship fight, wasn't made. In our Spence versus Ugas fight, I made Errol Spence pledge that the winner would follow with no excuses for the fight for all four belts. The truth is, Errol Spence did his part. He signed his contract, and Crawford took his $15 million contract in a historic boxing fight and responded with excuses and announcing his fight with David Avanesian for $10 million. But it's good that these things happen. So many fans give more value to the fighters who always want to fight against the best, who always want to give great fights to the fans. And it says hashtag 54 miracles. I don't really know what that means. So your Dennis Ugas is convinced that Terence Crawford is and was the holdup, and he is the one that made excuses. Now, I know you're not going to like the rest of this commentary, some of you, but the great ego Stradamus strikes again. I got to be the best in the world. I shook up the world. Oh my gosh, I make it look good. I make it look pretty. You listen to my videos, I'm always on the front line. I give you my opinion. And then, just like a fine wine, it just gets better over time. Said the same thing. Now you hear your Dennis Ugas saying what I've been telling you. The issue has been with Terence Crawford. That's my honest opinion. I give it to you real. That uncut, that raw, that cocaína, that puro, right? Because, again, it has nothing to do with Crawford as a fighter, but everything to do with Crawford as a businessman. If you think your value and your worth is something that is not on paper, then that creates complexities, which means that either Errol Spence and Al Haymon, the A-side, would have to bend or budge or fold, knowing that they're in the leveraged position, or rightfully so, the B-side would have to fold. Like, just, and this concept is so easy for everybody to understand when it comes to certain fighters. For example, when Canelo, when his stock was higher, if he's fighting Caleb Plant, Caleb Smith, Billy Joe Saunders, Avni Yildirim, it's almost understood by all parties that Canelo is the deal and Canelo is the A side, and Caleb Plant, Caleb Smith, Billy Joe Saunders, Yildirim will all be making less than Canelo. They'll walk out first. They don't get top billing, you know, these types of things. But some of those same boxing fans who completely understand it for Canelo, that he's the A side in those equations, or was at those times or whatever, they somehow don't see that Errol Spence and PBC have created a bigger brand with Errol Spence, and he is entirely in the driver's seat, no pun intended, but he's the man, and he's the A-side, he's the big fish, he's been telling you, you know? And people want these mercy points, and they want some leniency. That's just not how business works. The business, like, listen, I'm going to tell you straight up, and if you can't absorb this information and understand it, then you're probably not cut out for business. Business is not here to be your friend. Business is not here to tell you what you want to hear. Business is as business does. And at the end of the day, the business either A, makes sense, or B, it doesn't. Or you at least think the business will be profitable and make sense. That's it. Without a successful blueprint and a profitable business, you will be out of business. So I told you, this is just what Ugas is saying. It's Crawford. He has no, listen to how many people, and they say you will be judged by your peers. Crawford at this point is being judged by his peers. Bob Arum told you, Crawford needs representation. Eddie Hearn, another completely different. Eddie Hearn and Bob Arum don't necessarily get along. They're from two different places of the world, England, and Bob Arum's from New York, right? They're saying the same thing. Eddie Hearn too said that Crawford's fight will be a bust with David Avanesian, which it was, you know, in terms of financially. He says Crawford needs representation. Why would Al Haymon and PBC want to put up this grandiose, you know, big guarantee for a fight that we don't know where it will sell based on mostly Crawford, his side? You know, we don't really know because he's never turned in successful numbers per se, right? And so on and so forth. Derek James, now you have Ugas, Boxer Ego been telling you. I mean, how many people have to tell you the same thing for you to be like, hey, maybe they know what they're talking about? So Ugas is telling you. He says he doesn't blame Errol Spence. And again, it's worse because you're judged by your peers. You could say, oh, Boxer Ego, he don't know nothing. He's not the fighter. Okay, well, guess what? Ugas is the fighter, and he beat Terrence Crawford two times, one in the Pan Am Games, I believe, in the amateurs. And he's saying the same thing that Boxer Ego says. So I can't be that bad. And I'll probably make a separate video about it, but a lot of people going over the deep end because that's what they do. That's what the haters are going to do. And I don't want to even spend too much time, but Errol Spence versus Keith Thurman is a great fight, amazing fight. I will support it. All the people who are hating and saying, oh, why is he fighting? Oh, 54 and all that. Some of the same people didn't say anything to Terrence Crawford for fighting David Avanesian. And David Avanesian was ranked below Keith Thurman in all sanctioning bodies. So it's funny that Errol Spence is held to this standard. He's already done the heavier lifting and he's already collected three belts versus Crawford, who has one belt in his first fight at welterweight, all facts. And Crawford, who has the lacking resume in this division and only one belt versus three and hasn't financially been a success in the same way in terms of butts and seats and attendance records and blah, 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 pay-per-view sales. He's held to no standard, and Errol Spence is under a microscope. Oh, why is he fighting Errol Spence? Why is he fighting Keith Thurman? But the same people said to Terrence Crawford, fight David Avanesian. Go ahead, brother. Get your money. Oh, support black-owned business and all this stuff. So why can't it be Errol Spence? Go get your money. Why is it only Terrence Crawford? Go get your money. Go get your M's. And not to mention, Keith Thurman has always been a better fighter in my book than David Avanesian. So a lot of y'all sound sick, demented, twisted, that are complaining about Errol Spence in any weight fighting a Keith Thurman who has one loss, but were okay and say, bud, get your money, when he pulled out of negotiations that we could have got this fight with Errol Spence and PBC to go a whole separate way on a different separate app and flop. And just because I'm the best in the world, the best that's ever done it, the best there is, the best there was, the best there ever will be. This is from Steven Espinoza of Showtime. And he was responding to a fan. He said, I said nice thing, yada, yada, yada. Bud Crawford didn't, quote, need to fight in 2022. He decided he wanted to late in the process without telling anyone else. The Spence fight could have happened in January 2023, and he was given full transparency in writing applicable to a fight in both 2020 or 2023. Boom. So, again, the Bud Buddies can stay in delusion or whatever. Oh, he didn't receive transparency. Errol Spence on Twitter told Bud, hey, you were granted transparency. You could prove me wrong by posting the contract. This is 2 months ago at this point, and Bud never posted the contract. Steven Espinoza of Showtime, who works with Al Haymon and PBC, corroborating the same thing. Transparency was there. Bud chose to fight in December. He could have stuck to the program and fought Errol Spence. So Ugas is right. Boxer Ego's right. I'm the best in the business, and I'm out.
The future is now. The Hibernation 5s by Kenichi Bear. Hybrid gaming and lifestyle headphones. Out of the box, you can connect to any console or PC. Bluetooth ready with a low latency USB adapter, color RGB, and extreme bass mode. The Hibernation 5s adjust to you. Whether you need a gaming, travel, gym, or lifestyle headphones, the Hibernation's got you covered. The new Hibernation 5s, link in the description. Customize the way you hear the world. Welcome to the nation.